As I get out of bed, I remember the spring play. I wonder if attending a play would help cheer Ellen up.
Sure, you know what? Let's invite her.
I head down to Horse Hall and knock on her door. No one answers. Ellen, are you there? The door opens.
Sorry, I was afraid you were... someone coming to yell at me.
No, of course not. I came here to cheer you up. Would you like to go to the play with me on Friday?
Oh, okay.
Good. Now, don't you need to get ready for class?
Yes.
I'll see you later, then. I think she'll be okay. I hope.
All you can do is hope. Okay, let's do a black, see if we got anything to catch up on there. And then red, blue, green, and white. Okay, no new spells, so I just got stressed for no good reason. Well, poo. That's not what you want to see. Fire.
Ellen and I are walking back to Wolf Hall after her classes.
Look for her some evening this week before I go home for spring break. Just to be sure.
Right, but we have to be sure we're not being watched. We don't know whether Potsdam has found out about Musette or not, or whether she intends to do anything about her, but we don't want to lead a search right to her. So if...
There you are! I've been looking for you!
Is that?
I look around, but I can't see anyone.
Who's there?
Minnie?
Minnie! Why can't I see you?
I'm cloaked. Please, I need to talk to you. Both of you, in private. Franco, may I come into your room?
I don't know how Ellen would feel about that, Minnie. Do you have that cloak, the cloak of invisibility or whatever?
All right.
What's going on?
A moment later, there's a shimmering in the air and Minnie appears.
Sorry, I'm trying to keep a low profile at the moment. I heard about what happened with you and the camera.
Oh.
I don't blame you. Though Franco should have known better.
What right does she have to blame me for this? She hardly knows me.
But that's spilled milk now. I came to tell you some things you might not have heard as a wild seed. Oh, and please don't mention this conversation to Professor Potsdam or anyone else.
All right.
The reason so many things like cameras and CD players are banned on campus is to prevent any mixing of magic and electronics. It's very strictly forbidden. They don't want any student to be tempted to experiment.
I know already! If I don't behave, I could be expelled and lose my mind. Professor Potsdam told me that.
You know that in theory, but you might think that because you're one of the top students in our class, you know that's true. So you might think you could talk your way out of it. Don't! You can't win that fight. There was a student here last year or so that I heard about. I think she was a snake. Her name was Musette.
Luckily, Minnie's eyes are downcast, and she doesn't seem to notice our reactions to that name.
Okay, so she didn't actually know about Musette, but Musette just kind of naturally came up into the conversation because she wanted to warn us about mixing electronics and magic? Dang, Minnie.
She got good grades. And she got interested in magical technology. She had a good reason, but that didn't matter. She was just a student, a wild seed, and she was disobedient. That made her dangerous. So they expelled her. They stripped her magic, they wiped her memories, and they... Do you understand what I'm saying? Musette was a good student with special circumstances, and it didn't save her.
And now she's just an ordinary girl again for the rest of her life. Isn't she? Does Minnie know about the Echo Moosehead left behind?
She's gone now.
What are you not saying?
It doesn't matter.
Tell me, what do you know about Moosette?
She's dead! Because the magical world abandoned her!
What?
When a wild seed leaves the school, no one talks about them anymore. No one looks for them. Moosette had a heart condition. It was being managed, first by her doctors, then by magic while she was here. Then the school wiped her memory and sent her home, and never followed up to be sure she was all right.
I don't understand. She went home. Wouldn't she have the same doctors as before, then?
But if, if she made the choice to have everyone's memories erased, and then her memory got erased, she might have just died from this heart condition she didn't know she had.
But people who know a wild seed sometimes get confused while we're gone. They forget. Her appointments and records must have been all mixed up.
Not mixed up. Erased. To stop anyone from worrying about the checkup she wasn't having while she was at school. Most likely, no one remembered she was ill until her heart started to fail again.
And if she'd been using healing spells, the tests might come out wrong. They might give her the wrong medicine. And that could kill someone if they're unlucky.
Aren't doctors supposed to fix people?
It's not magic, you know.
I shouldn't have told you. No one's supposed to know.
How do you know? How does Minnie know so much? Man, I gotta date this girl.
My head wavers back and forth. I don't know what to think. Do the professors know?
I don't know. Why would they? She's not one of us anymore. They don't care about her or anyone else we lose.
How do you know about it, then?
That's not important.
Is she just making this whole thing up to scare Ellen into compliance? If so, it might backfire if Ellen investigates the story and finds out it's a lie. But why would she make up a story like this? Being expelled is bad enough, surely.
Ellen, I hope you understand. I'm not trying to be mean. I'm trying to help you. It's easy to think that something's not fair, and that if you just point that out to the right people, it'll be fixed. But that's not always what happens. I don't want you to be another sad story. Please don't challenge this. Just follow the rules, okay?
I already promised Franco I wouldn't do any more reckless experiments.
Oh! Well, that's good then. I should really go. Don't tell anyone that we talked about this, alright? But you can always talk to me if you need advice.
She hurries out of the room and Ellen and I look at each other. For a moment, neither of us knows what to say.
We ended up alone in your room again.
Oops.
Do you think it's true about Moosette?
I don't know. It doesn't make sense. We worked out earlier that our Moosette couldn't be a real ghost. The pieces don't fit. Of course, if she died after leaving the school, it might not have any effect on the echo she left behind. We should talk to her, see if she knows anything about this heart problem.
Right. I'd better go for now.
She leans in for a quick kiss, which extends to a slightly longer one before she pulls away, blushing, and makes her exit. I am left alone with my thoughts, but I don't know what to do with them.
I know, man. I feel ya. This Moosette thing just keeps getting more complicated by the second. I don't even know what to think, man. Hello.
A heart condition. It's something you would have known about before you came here. Do you remember anything like that? Because no one lives forever.
What's that?
Something I remember saying. I don't know. I can't remember anything about my heart. I don't remember it hurting or being worried about it. I still definitely don't remember dying. But I remember being in a hurry to get things done. That makes sense, right? If I knew I was going to die...
Maybe you're giving off that aura, too, because Ellen keeps feeling like she needs to rush with you.
You shouldn't have thought you were dying. Magic was supposed to fix you.
Maybe she didn't trust the magic would really work.
Yeah, well, sounds like I would have had good reason not to trust them. If it's true, I don't know. I just don't know. I've been feeling... scared lately. I thought it was just because of...
Before our eyes, Musette's form starts to fade away before reversing its progress back to near solidity.
That. What's happening to you? It keeps getting harder and harder to hold myself together. Maybe it's just like my subconscious doing a manifesting thing?
A what?
Because I can't remember dying, so it's making me live out the whole wasting away. Like it's my karma.
I don't think that's how karma works.
If I'm already dead, I can't die again, can I? We don't know if the other Musette died. We don't have any proof.
If Potsdam saw Ellen's pictures and is trying to banish you, that might be why you're fading.
But we don't know that either. We don't know anything. That's life. Or death. Or something. I don't know how long I can hold on tonight. Well, what do we do now? I'm going home for spring break. I can look for records of Musette Ellis then. If I find an obituary, at least we'll know it's true.
If Musette is really dead, should we tell anyone else? I don't want to imagine the look on Grabner's face if he finds out that he failed her so badly, but hiding the truth solves nothing. And what about Damien? If Musette did die as a fallen wild seed, how could her ghost appear here as a witch? Is it like Ellen first thought, that her spirit can't rest until her story is known? Or were we right before that our ghost is just the memory of Musette's magic, and has nothing to do with what happened to her other self? If so, and that Musette died, then ours is all that's left of her. All we have are questions and never any answers. When Ellen comes back, maybe we'll have more information. Until then, you should save your strength.
Maybe you should see if you feel stronger in different places, like your old room, or if it's better away from them. I can do ghost science! I hope.
The color drains from Musette's appearance as she fades away.
We didn't really get a chance to talk about the science problem.
There's nothing to talk about there. Whether Minnie's story is true or not, the one thing you can be absolutely sure about is that science is dangerous.
Well, testing what makes a ghost weaker or stronger is still science, even if it doesn't use technology.
Do you have to call it that? You make me worry every time you say science.
Like magicology?
Not that. That still sounds like technology.
Thaumaturgy? Arcanistry?
I shrug. I have no idea what those words mean. So they don't make me nervous anyway.
That's really weird.
Don't use technology, don't talk about science. Then everything should be okay.
Yeah.
Whatever the truth is, things didn't turn out okay for Musette.
I guess no matter how you slice it, that's true. Oh, Ellen, please stop playing with fire. You make me nervous, girl. Okay. So we are at the, we're at the play.
After I pay for my ticket, I can go inside. I was not at all sure what to expect from an American musical. What I get turns out to be a mix of song, dance, action, and special effects. Do ordinary schools allow students to wave flaming swords like that? I've never seen plants with eyes and teeth before, I wonder if it's a fantasy invention or if they're coming in the near other world.
Excuse me. A lot of air.
The tone fluctuates between comedy and high drama, as each character struggles with their own flaws and desires.
I just realized, if we're watching the play, we must have bypassed the whole Damien thing? Right? Because didn't that happen before the play? But surely he would have tried it on somebody else and still got expelled.
One by one, they give in to temptation, and by the end, it appears humanity will be overrun by bloodthirsty vegetation. Despite that, the final song remains upbeat and the audience cheers. We head back out into the dark school hallways. There's too much of a crowd near the theater itself, so we go a bit further to find a quiet place.
So, I guess I should say goodbye for a little while.
I'll miss you. Over spring break, I mean.
Me too.
So, be careful. Find out what you can, but don't get into trouble. Don't talk to anyone about magic. Especially the other Musette, if she's alive and you find her. And come back safely.
I will. I have to go before my sister finds out I was with a boy.
She hurries away. Ellen's too smart to make a mistake. I should trust her. There's nothing to worry about. Right? All I can do is go back to my room to wait for Grabner.
For our lovely swamp vacation. Going to the bayou.
The break has ended and everyone is returning to the dorms for the final stretch. 1 month left. I waved hello to Donald and William in the halls earlier, but the person that I most want to see is... Aha! Someone's knocking on my door. Ellen! I reach out my arms to her, then drop them when she doesn't seem to know how to respond.
Well, come on, it's a hug.
Welcome back. It's good to see you.
Ah, it's good to see you too.
Please, come inside.
Right.
I lead her into my room and she sucks in a deep breath, her shoulders lifting. Does my room smell funny? I hope not. How was your holiday?
What?
Her shoulders drop. You went home for spring break. Did you have a good time?
Don't you want to hear what I found out about Musette?
Well, eventually, sure. But you're my girlfriend. You're the one I care about.
Really?
Of course, really. Why is she being so insecure again all of a sudden? Oh. Did you have problems with your family over the break? She pulls in another deep breath, more slowly this time, and then sighs.
Well, Jenny turned 13, and it looks like she's not a witch.
Jenny?
My little sister.
Oh, right. I forgot. I'm sorry. Since Ellen's a wild seed, it was almost impossible that her sister would turn out to be magical as well. Did you want her to be a witch?
I don't know. It would have meant having someone else at home who understood. Someone I could talk to. But we've always been so different. I don't know if she'd understand me even if she did have magic too. And she's happier this way. She's popular at school, and her parents adore her, and now nothing has to change. She was afraid of ending up like me, and now she won't. So that's good, right?
I don't know her. It's you I'm worried about. What did they say to you?
Nothing, really. We didn't talk much. I mostly stayed in my room when I wasn't at the library.
Did they ask about how things were going at school?
Not really. I mean, Mama asked, but I just said fine, and then she dropped it. I don't know what else I could say, since I had to keep all the magic secret.
You could always talk about playing sports. There's nothing magical about that. Most of the time, anyway.
We don't have a competitive team, though. We don't play against other schools. That's what they'd want to hear. Who we beat. I don't feel safe talking to them about anything that matters to me. It's easier to stay out of sight. So I ignore them, and they ignore me.
That's not likely to make things any better. Mm. Have you been thinking more about what Professor Potsdam said? About making your family forget you?
But I don't want them to forget me! I should tell you what I found out about Musette.
All right.
It's true. I found the story. Musette Ellis died of complications from a long-standing heart condition. It made the papers because her parents were charged with neglect.
Charged?
They were arrested because failing to look after your child's health is a crime. And it wasn't their fault! They didn't have any choice! It was the wizard who mucked everything up!
It shouldn't have happened. Whoever handled Musette's case should have taken responsibility. Grabner knew Musette had been sent home, but he believed she was safe. Did he know that her heart was damaged? Who was in charge of altering the family's memories? If this were my domain, I could investigate, change procedures, make sure it didn't happen again. I don't have that power in America.
Dang, how much power do you have where you're from?
Even if you're responsible, wiping people's minds just because they're inconvenient is wrong. I know we have to protect the other world and magic and everything, but that doesn't make it good. Sometimes all we have are terrible choices.
Ellen.
I know. I heard Minnie. No arguing. Keep my head down. Don't challenge the authorities. I don't want them to take away my mind.
I hate seeing her so distressed. I wish I could make it better. I almost wish she'd never heard of Musette so she didn't have to be so afraid. Ordinary freshmen don't carry these burdens. Her life would be happier if she didn't know.
There's that, but the example of Musette might make her less experimental about mixing science and magic than she would otherwise be. Possibly.
But there's no way for her to have that innocence back without taking away her memories, which I would never want to do. I suppose we have to tell Musette.
I'll do it.
What?
I want to talk to her alone. She's going to be scared and upset. I think it'll be easier if you're not there.
I suppose there's no reason that I would need to be involved. Musette is really more Ellen's friend than she is mine. If an echo of a ghost can be said to be anyone's friend. You'll tell me if anything important happens, right?
Of course. We still have to find a way to stop her spirit from fading. We'll need your help.
Right. I hope I sound more optimistic than I feel. I would love to save Musette and give Ellen some kind of victory, but I don't have any idea how.
I really hope she doesn't get herself into trouble. I'm nervous about the fact that she's going alone.
I asked Ellen to go to the play with me on Friday.
Minnie's intervention.
Minnie came to talk to Ellen and warn her about the dangers of mixing magic and technology. Unexpectedly, she provided new information about Musette. Minnie claimed that Musette died after being sent home because of magical disruption to her medical treatment. Can that be true?
Fading spirit.
There's no evidence yet about whether the real Musette is dead or not, but the ghost we've been talking to appears to be losing strength. Can a ghost die? We don't even know why she's here to begin with. All we can do is keep researching.
Waiting for word.
Ellen and I attended the school musical together, and then she went off to spend spring break with her family. She's supposed to investigate a few things while she's away and report back. I hope she stays safe.
Lack of family support.
Ellen saw her family over spring break, but can't find any way to talk to them because they're not part of the magical world, which makes her feel more rejected and lonely. But she doesn't want to give up on her family because she disapproves of magically tampering with memories, especially after the consequences that had for Musette.
So heavy. Also, I just realized we haven't had a chorale meeting in forever. Weren't we supposed to, like, perform something that had to go along with the musical? Am I crazy? Alright. Gym, red, blue, green, white. I just don't know anymore.
I see someone leaning against the wall near my room. Hey, Luke, looking for me?
I could be.
Ah, it's April Fool's Day. I will try a yellow one this time.
I would like a yellow one, thank you. He shakes a little yellow bean into my palm and I pop it into my mouth. Instead of sugar, a bright burst of spice covers my tongue. In fact, it tastes rather like mustard. That's pretty good.
You liked it?
Was I not supposed to?
Okay. So, no matter what, Franco just likes it. Alright, done that before.
Franco?
I open the door and let Ellen into the room. This doesn't look like it's going to be a happy conversation.
Sorry. I talked to Musette.
How did she take the news?
Well, she's not happy about her other self being dead, but she says it's still not real to her. She has no memory of leaving the school or being ill. She barely remembers her family. She says it's like hearing a story about strangers. She's more worried about what's happening to her now.
Is she still having trouble with fading?
That's why it took me so long to talk to her.
Maybe this is nature taking its course. Musette is dead, after all.
But she did tell me something important. She found a place that makes her feel stronger and more solid. It just wasn't where I would have expected.
What place is that?
Come and see!
She takes my hand and pulls me out of my room. And out onto the school grounds.
Over here, by this tree in the starlight. I mean, it was starlight then. Not now, obviously. It was really dark, too. There was no moon last night, so I couldn't look around very much. But this is where Musette said she feels most at home. I don't know why, though. I mean, we know she wasn't buried here.
This place. This tree.
Yeah, I'm like, isn't this where we had, like, that weird... I don't know. That weird magic episode where we were so mad at Grabner and we reached out to, like, the woodland spirits. Wild magic, that's what it was.
I remember this. I remember being here in the fall when the leaves were brown. I remember reaching out for the wild magic. I remember a flash of red hair.
Oh, was that... Oh, I forgot about that. I thought it was, like, Von Brun or Angela or something.
I thought I'd imagined it.
Imagined what?
I shake my head. How can I explain what happened when I don't understand it myself? I think I saw Musette's ghost here once a long time ago, before we met her properly.
That proves it! There must be some connection!
I feel a faint rush of magic as Ellen invokes a spell. She walks all around the tree, looking hopeful, then sighs.
Huh. I don't sense any illusions. It's still just a tree.
And far too old a tree to have grown up over a grave, even if Musette's body were here. I open my senses to check for spirits nearby, but I only detect myself and Ellen. No trace of Musette registers at the moment.
There must be something...
She thinks for a moment.
In our stories, ghosts often linger around an object that was meaningful to them. Maybe something like that crystal necklace Musette wears. Maybe the original necklace is here.
Why would her necklace be buried under a tree?
I mean, if she knew she was going to be expelled, she might have buried something there. Maybe.
Not under a tree, in a tree. She might have hidden it here in a hollow. Maybe even with a hidden message for whoever finds it.
Why would she do that?
Because it's romantic and exciting, imagining someone finding your secret treasure in the future and thinking about you.
Did you ever do something like that?
Maybe. And we read the same kind of books.
Ellen does understand how Musette thinks better than I do, being a wild seed herself. Ellen looks up at the tree.
I don't see anything down here. If there's a hiding place, it must be higher up. Can you climb?
Sure, I've been climbing trees since I was a kid.
I was never any good at it. I'll be right here.
I wrap my legs around the trunk and begin to climb. I don't know what I'm looking for, but Ellen suggested a cavity in the tree itself would be a good hiding place, so I carefully feel the bark and the branches as I move, checking for hollows. Suddenly, my hand falls through a thick tangle of spider webs. Yeah! I pull my hand back and look at it, checking for angry arachnids. I don't see anything crawling, but the filthy clumps of material sticking to my fingers look suspiciously artificial. I may have found something. I pull away the cottony webs to reveal. Ellen, I think I found a machine.
What? Bring it down and let me see.
I am not touching that. What if it explodes?
Does it look like a bomb?
How would I know what a bomb looks like?
Well, describe it.
It's like a narrow box made out of dark metal. There's a glass panel on the front, and I can see little plastic wheels inside. I think there are buttons on the top.
That doesn't sound like a bomb. Are there any labels you can read?
With great trepidation, I cast a light spell nearby so that I can see the device more clearly. Baytalk, Vox, Mic, Pop-up, Eject, Play, Rewind.
It's a tape recorder!
What is a tape recorder doing on Iris Academy grounds? That's definitely against the rules. It could be a trap.
It must have belonged to Musette. It's her hidden message. Bring it down. I want to see.
I am not comfortable with this, but I can't say no to Ellen. Gingerly, I pick up the device and clamber down the tree.
Could you not have written something, girl? Why do you gotta get me in trouble?
Ellen lights up at the sight of the tape recorder.
This is so exciting! Press the play button.
Wait. We know that Musette was expelled over some kind of experiment mixing magic and technology. If she enchanted this object somehow, activating it might cause something far worse than an explosion. I cautiously extend my senses, checking for lingering charms. There's no sign of any magic in this, but it feels empty somehow. As if it held mana once, but not anymore.
Yeah. See? Hey! My theory was right! Oh, yeah. Maybe the last of the mana has just drained away now. Because Possum talked about how slowly over time it just dissipates.
I suppose that means it's safe. Or at least probably not going to cause the end of the world.
May I turn it on now?
All right. Her finger depresses the play button with an audible click.
My name is Musette. At least that's what my mother named me. It sounds so boring and old-fashioned.
I hear Musette's voice coming from the hole in the tree, though it sounds somewhat distorted and shaky.
I want something short and snappy. Something cool. Not Muse. Maybe M or Eddie.
The words are familiar. Too familiar. I'm sure I remember Musette, our Musette, saying that before. Ellen clicks another button and the voice stops.
This must be Musette's diary.
Aren't diaries usually books?
Modern technology. Actually, kind of old-fashioned technology. You don't see these much anymore. Do you think...
She presses several more buttons. I'm not sure what she's doing.
My boyfriend is a demon with blue skin and claw nails and purple wings like a bat. People say his blood is cursed and he's doomed to turn evil and plunge into hell.
I've heard her say that. Those exact words.
Well, if this is her diary, it would make sense that she'd say the same kinds of things.
She recorded herself.
I'm not that confused by technology. I know what a recorder is.
No, I mean, she recorded herself!
I don't understand.
Musette knew that her heart was bad and she might die young. So what did she do about it? What if the reason we have a ghost is that Musette tried to make a copy of herself?
That's... not possible.
Isn't it? White magic works with feelings and memories. Spirit echoes replays imprinted emotions from the past.
I don't know how spirit echoes works.
There must be a way to invoke that process deliberately and make an imprint of yourself.
You can't copy a soul. People are far more complex than one or two emotions, and Musa was just a wild seed freshman. Not that there's anything wrong with being a wild seed freshman.
But she had all her words and thoughts recorded here. Couldn't she fill them with magic and bring them to life somehow?
What sort of irresponsible mad wizard would even attempt such a thing? A wild seed with no boundaries about magical technology and no sense of self-preservation.
It would explain why our Musette's memory is so mixed up. She could only know whatever was on the tape recording. And of course she would still be a witch. The recording couldn't be updated after Musette was expelled.
Even if that was possible somehow, there's a problem with your idea. The tape recorder is not enchanted.
No. Not anymore. Don't you see? It's empty. Because there was something inside it that got out. Our Musette. Even if I don't know how.
I might.
What?
It's complicated, but... The day I first saw her by this tree, there was a magical surge right before that. Which I caused. I suppose it's possible that it somehow disrupted the spell on this machine.
So that's it. That's where she came from.
I don't know. We've had a lot of ideas about Musette, and they've usually turned out to be wrong.
Not all of them. And this time, there's evidence and the pieces fit. She's not a ghost. She's... a magical creation. But that doesn't tell us anything about why she's fading.
A spell construct can't survive forever on this side of the spiral gate. There's not enough free mana. If that's what she is, it makes much more sense why she would be fading away. As soon as she was born, her time was limited.
Oh man, the irony of the situation. A girl with a heart condition, who was afraid of dying and her time being short, tries to make a copy of herself so that she can continue living. And then said creation, as soon as she was born, also had a limited lifespan. But not because of a heart this time. Sheesh. I was not ready for this storyline.
So what can we do to help her? Do we put her back into the tape recorder?
First of all, that's incredibly illegal and dangerous, and exactly the sort of thing that got Musette expelled. Second, if you're right, she didn't become a person who could move around and talk to us until after she got out of the machine.
So even if we could, she'd be trapped in there all alone. What do we do?
First, I'm going to put this thing back in the tree before someone sees it and you get in trouble with Potsdam.
Right.
Then we should talk to Musette and find what she thinks.
And do research to see if we can find some way to preserve her.
Can we teleport her to the other world somehow? But then how do you explain that a wild seed girl is running around the other world?
Right. If it was my careless action that brought Musette into our world, I am in a way responsible for her. What am I supposed to do?
I think we need to talk to Grabner again. I need an adult. Oh my goodness, Corral is still a thing.
Since this is our last month of school, it's time to step up chorale preparations for the end of year sing-along. It's going to be held on the last Friday before finals. Excuse me again. And is designed to be a cheerful, stress-relieving experience to help out anyone that needs the boost. The chorale will perform a few songs first to warm up the crowd before we invite them to join in, but it won't be a formal concert in the way that the holiday performance was. After that, everyone will be invited to sing with us. We'll stick to popular songs and pass out sheet music to make it as easy as possible to take part. Of course, we're still practicing the songs ourselves ahead of time so that we can carry the music even if the newcomers falter. Ray has brought in a few of her friends from the drama club to sit in on our session, now that their play season has ended. Ellen didn't show up. It's not like her to be absent. I hope she's not ill. Maybe she's busy doing research and decided that was more important than Corell. I would have skipped with her if she'd asked me, but now that I'm here, I'd better stay put. I can read more later tonight. Blaze claps for attention.
Disney songs today, I think. Everyone on your feet, ready to stretch and breathe. If we stay focused, I won't make you do Small World.
Thank you.
I'm not entirely sure why everyone laughed at that, but at least we're having a good time.
Franco, you don't know Small World? How uncultured can you be? Oh boy.
After most students are in bed, Ellen and I sneak out onto the grounds for a meeting with Musette. If she feels stronger near the tree where she used to be confined, then it's probably better to stay nearby. But how much longer can she last? Musette stares at the tape recorder.
So I was like a genie in a bottle? And then the bottle broke?
Now is probably not the time to have a detailed discussion about the djinn.
That is super weird. I don't buy it. I'm a person, not a recording. But where's your proof? It's not science without proof. Listen!
Before I can stop her, Ellen presses the play button again.
Put your hands behind your back and try to take a bite out of the apple while it swings away from you.
Oh man, it's creepy that her eyes are gone.
As the words continue to fall out of the machine, Musette begins to recite along with them, every breath uncannily matched to the recording.
I told Damien it works better with a partner to push the apple back, and he said we didn't need a festival to...
Make it stop! Ellen presses another button and the recitation cuts off. That was very strange.
Are you all right? I'm not real.
I'm not a person. Just an echo. Just a broken old tape.
Don't say that!
I'm not Musette. I'm just a thing.
I don't care about the other Musette. I never met her and she's dead. But you are my friend. You're not a parrot. All the times we talked, the experiments we planned, that wasn't on this tape. That was you. Maybe you started from a recording, but you have thoughts and feelings of your own. You exist!
Ellen's impassioned defense seems to bring the spirit girl back to her senses.
Thank you. You are too cute.
I know this is a lot to think about.
Which proves that you're thinking and feeling.
But there's a bigger problem. You're made of magic, and you're not designed to survive in this world. If we don't do something, you're going to disappear completely.
And you don't know what to do.
Not yet. I've read about spirits being bound to magical artifacts.
I don't want to go back in a bottle. That would be like cutting off my fingers and pulling out my eyeballs.
Ew.
I don't want to disappear either, but no one lives forever. The other Musette died. Maybe that's my fate too.
I'm not giving up yet. We only found the recorder 2 days ago. There's so much more to research.
I love it when you get inventive.
We should get back inside before someone sees us.
But we'll come back another night.
Well, I'm not going anywhere. I'm just gonna hang out here, pretend to be a harbinger of doom or something.
She drifts up into the trees, fading from view. Ellen leans her head on my shoulder.
I can't believe I once thought that having magic was going to make life easy.
I hug her. Nothing's easy all the time. That's why we need smart people like you to sort things out.
I'm not that smart.
I think you are.
Huh.
Come on, let's get to bed. Worn out from the week's revelations, she doesn't even blush at that, only nods and walks away.
Aw, you really know Ellen's down in the dumps when she doesn't blush. Well, I guess I'm studying. Man, this root is so heavy. So heavy. At least that explains, though, why we didn't have the whole Musette storyline in the first game. Because there was no Franco to awaken her spirit in that tree. Or in that recorder. So well thought out. Well done with that. Okay, so you guys are arguing again.
I don't want a scandal.
Alright, let's read about this. Okay, we did that. A recording.
Ellen and I located some records that the original Musette left in a tree. It seems that we have been talking to a spellborn spirit. If that's true, what can we do about it?
Existence.
Ellen and I broke the news to our Musette and saw a demonstration of her nature when we used the old tape recorder, but we're no closer to figuring out how to keep her alive.
We really need help with this one.